Hi, this is the part of the series where I'm going to cover the welding that I did for the support legs on Jerome's extension table. Now, I did not have access to this saw. I only saw it one time in person before I started building this thing. It's about 20 miles away. And so I had to come up with a support system, one that would not interfere with his router table, and that was also flexible, and because I did not know the final distance, the relationship from the way the angle iron of the Biesemeyer style guide rail system was going to relate to the saw, which in turn would relate to the mobile carriage. So I came up with an articulating system that as it rotated, it would be at a different distance. And so I could choose a place, and then I also had another, not only could I change the angle this way in relationship to the vertical, but then I could change the height by adding a nut on or a bolt onto the end of the it was a nut onto the end of this of a piece of 1-inch pipe, and this was then welded to a plate that you'll see that then got bolted to the mobile carriage. So that's what I'm getting ready to cover here. And I want to give you a little bit of background why I chose this. And the reason I did this is because I use these all the time. I have a whole bunch of these, and I just use these constantly. So just if you take, this is 1 1/4 inch, and this is 1-inch Schedule 40 pipe. And as you'll see, they just sleeve together just beautifully. Not too tight where they get bound under any circumstance, but just tight enough that they align right. And then if you put weld a nut onto it, you can have a handle or a bolt that comes in here, and I mean the it pins it and locks it just beautifully. So what this had was this was welded to the bottom of the angle iron, and I did not even cut this off until I got over to Jerome's with the nut on it. So I had extra length, and then I had about 2 inches of adjustment for final height, so I could articulate it and change the height and just dial it in until we had it just perfect for it to sit just right on that mobile base that I welded up. But this combination of things is something I do all the time. You know, you simply pipe notch something, put it up here. Oh, it's got kind of a burr on it. You can pipe notch all kinds of things together. You can pipe notch the 1 to the 1 1/2 to the 1 1/4, or the 1 1/4 to the 1 1/4 is what I did. And just create a whole array of really interesting locking mechanisms really cheap. And another one of my favorite things to do, I'm not showing it in this series, but I'll show it at some time, is I like to weld these up. And this is just a drop of 1-inch Schedule 40 pipe and some 1 1/4 inch stubs here at the end, and I call these dog bones. And here's an example of one right here. I've got them throughout my shop. This is another example of using the 1 1/4 inch pipe together. So this is an extension support for my drill press that I'm sitting next to, and I have one on either side. I release the handle, just a flat welded to a nut that's welded to a bolt that's welded to the nut is welded to the pipe, and I can raise and lower this and dial it in just perfect. But look at this dog bone here. So I can just release this, swing it around, and lock it in any position that I like. You know, so these are just fantastic. They fit on this size pipe so beautifully. And then, you know, here I've got this one. So if I want to take this out and now put it up on another part of my drill press, if I'm not using this, I can. So this is just something I do all the time, because the Schedule 40 pipe is really available and it's very reasonable. A lot of times you can even get scraps of it. But the smaller sizes than this, they don't sleeve together quite so well. And the next size combination of sizes up is too big for standard stuff. So this 1 1/4 and 1 inch pipe, I mean, this just has so many uses to come up with shop fixtures. And that's what I did. I just, you know, I go with what I know, and I know this will work, and I was able to articulate that, you know, and just make it absolutely perfect, you know, I could change everything and then change the height and then lock it in place, and I know it wouldn't move, and I know it would be a super strong connection. The pipe is so strong, and when you weld it all the way around here like this, it's a serious, serious connection. Okay, well, that's what I'm getting ready to do here. So I just wanted it to make sense, and so you just didn't go, what are all these crazy little parts he's welding up here? So you'll see the pictures, and then so as you watch this, hopefully it'll make sense to you. But it was pretty much a necessity for this style because of the position of Jerome's router table, to not have any interference on that.